My name is Iris Feind. I'm a postgraduate teaching assistant.
I'm Louise Clunell. I'm the Education and Outreach Officer for MMU Special Collections.
I'm Ian Wadcock. I'm a senior lecturer in illustration and animation.
So about 2 years before the We Built This City exhibition was launched, I was asked to come up with some ideas for projects that could involve students from across the university. While I was doing that research, I came across a really lovely, quite modest little pamphlet that was called A Manchester Alphabet. And it was written and illustrated by a gentleman called Roger Oldham. And he had created an alphabet of Edwardian Manchester. So it was people, places, things that he had created poems and then illustrated those poems to make a really charming, humorous little booklet. And I immediately knew that this was the booklet that I wanted to base the project around. Now, because I'd worked with the School of Writing and the School of Art previously on crime lines and timelines, I took the book to them and showed it to their staff with the suggestion that we should do a contemporary update of a Manchester alphabet and invite our students to create a new set of poems and a new set of illustrations based on their experiences of Manchester.
It seemed like a really good idea to ask our poetry students from the MA in poetry at the Manchester Writing School if they would like to come up with some poetry. Ian then became involved because obviously we needed images, and any excuse to work with the School of Art is always great because we work so well together.
What it enables for the student is an opportunity to work without trying to predict what it is they think I want from the course. That they start to be themselves, they feel permission to be themselves. It brings students together in a very different way, and I think it creates a sense of belonging to the course and belonging to the university, which goes outside of the definition of a course programme or a relationship with a particular tutor. And I think a lot of this is about confidence building, and I think that's confidence for us as well. I think we gain confidence by actually saying, actually we can make this happen, we can create these publications, and that they are difficult to achieve, logistically difficult, but they have a life once they exist, which is really important in helping us tell the story of the courses that we're on, telling the story of the university, and I think telling the student's story more importantly than anything else.
I will take them here, and Louise usually prepares some objects, some artist books, and they're completely blown away by it because they just didn't know this existed. And I don't know why that is. It's such a shame because they always get so much out of it, because it takes them out of their comfort zone. It makes them write things, stories, poems that they wouldn't otherwise have written. And I think that's really interesting, and it's a shame that we don't do more of it.
What I like about having an agenda set within Special Collections for this is that it created a kind of a due reverence for the original publication, but a clear desire to create something which was ambitious and contemporary. And I think that resistance and the tensions that happen within a client-publishing relationship are quite hard to replicate. And I think this is a nice little model.
Absolutely.
To enable that. It does, I think, make them realise that archives are living resources.
Once the book had been published, that was not the end of A Manchester Alphabet's journey. So in this year, I've been working with students from the undergraduate history course. We've also been working with 8 primary schools from around Manchester in partnership with Historic England. So it's a project that keeps on growing, and I think that's the beauty of Special Collections. Although we're talking this morning about working with staff within the Faculty of Humanities and the Faculty of the School of Art, that people can come in and make links with Special Collections regardless of what discipline they're studying, because there's always a way to kind of explore that and use it in a way that can enrich students' learning and enhance the teaching and learning experience.